The government is introducing new counter-terrorism laws as it prepares for the potential return of foreign fighters, like the so-called bumbling jihadi. Kiwi Mark Taylor, who has fought for Islamic State, is being held in jail by Kurdish-led forces in Syria. But it's unclear what may happen to him with new fighting along the border. The terrorism suppression bill would allow the High Court to impose control orders on returning terrorists, and that could include restrictions like a curfew, electronic monitoring, as well as limiting access to mobile phones and the internet. And those orders could apply for up to 6 years. But with the Greens refusing to support the bill on humanitarian grounds, Justice Minister Andrew Little will have to look to National to pass the bill. And National says right now the bill isn't tough enough. Political reporter Yvette McCullough has more.
The bill would apply to the likes of Mark Taylor, the so-called bumbling jihadi who joined ISIS and is currently being detained by Kurdish forces in Syria. Right now, without a passport or any diplomatic support, his chances of coming home remain slim. But if he or any other New Zealanders like him do return, the Justice Minister, Andrew Little, says we need to be ready.
We started a review of our terrorism suppression laws last year. As we've been doing that review, obviously the situation in Syria has been changing and in the last couple of weeks changed quite rapidly. We have to be prepared for the possibility that New Zealanders and at least one New Zealander who has gone to that area for the purpose of terrorist fighting will come back to New Zealand, and we need to be prepared for that.
Mr Little says the High Court imposed control orders would only apply to a very, very small number of people and would be tailored to the individual circumstances, risks and rehabilitative needs, meaning the more serious the risk, the more restrictive the conditions. But the Greens' justice spokesperson, Goaz Garaman, is raising humanitarian red flags and warning this could end up catching people who aren't really terrorists.
What's actually frightening about this is that we're going to rely on evidence collected by foreign agencies that may have employed torture, where we know that that's actually not going to be reliable, or are actually targeted at political dissidents rather than actual terrorists.
Ms Garaman says there are already laws in place to deal with someone like Mark Taylor coming home, and she's calling this dog-whistling legislation.
Well, it's that kind of, tough on crime, war on terror language that, especially in a post-Christchurch world in New Zealand, has no place here. We know that it will rile up fear and anxiety about something that isn't a problem. We have terror law, we have policing mechanisms, let's rely on those.
But the Prime Minister rejects that.
No, absolutely not. This is a very practical response. We have obviously a new and emerging issue that the globe is trying to deal with. We've got to protect the safety of New Zealanders. We do have known individuals who have engaged in activity that we, of course, have strongly discouraged, that the law needs to now be able to respond to, and that's what this is about.
New Zealand First Leader Winston Peters says it would be extremely naive for the government to do nothing.
Do you not understand that this is an attack on the whole of Western civilization that you're looking at? The reality is, if someone came into this country and we didn't take the action we should have taken, when it's all over, you'd all be looking at us and screaming blue murder that we didn't act. Well, we're getting in first responsibly.
The Greens' objections mean Labour and New Zealand First will have to rely on National to get this over the line. But the party's leader, Simon Bridges, is making it clear he wants a tougher law.
The bill isn't strong enough and doesn't make New Zealanders safe enough. As there's changes we definitely believe have to be made. Effectively, they are changes that are the same or similar to provisions, mainly in Australia.
National wants the police to be able to detain returnees if necessary. It also wants to increase the maximum time control orders can remain in place and to lower the age limit for them from 18 to 14.
Regrettably, children, young people have been radicalised as close as across the ditch. And so no one takes any pleasure in this, but I think it's a situation where we need to have the scope, at least, for the High Court to go lower.
Mr Bridges says he wouldn't describe these changes as bottom lines, but he says he will be strongly urging Mr Little to adopt them all because he thinks New Zealanders will be less safe without them. From Parliament for Checkpoint, Yvette McCullough.